we return to Premiership action. Newcastle United facing off against Wolverhampton Wanderers. Wolves, who are struggling in the league at the moment, second from bottom, with just one win from the opening 10 games. One win, two draws and seven defeats. Newcastle United, on the other hand, on 17 points, have got 5 wins this season, up in 8th place. Newcastle should be relatively confident, but this match coming off the back of the international break of World Cup qualifiers, you see the condition my players are in, not so good. So let's start here. Shea Given will make way for Edouard Mendy. In fact, Ben Foster is going to make his Premier League debut today. Why not? Jude Bellingham will start ahead of Marco Verratti. Luan will start. Adama will start. Harry Kane, who scored twice, is going to be benched ahead of Andy Cole. Alan Saint-Maximin will start today ahead of Gareth Bale. And Kieran Knight will come onto the bench ahead of Lucas Podolski. Who else can I rest? Jamal Lascelles will come in for Martinez Quarta. Victor Ruiz will come onto the bench. No, Howard Bellis is good to go, actually. Ndombele, Alan Shearer. I know Alan Shearer doesn't look well, but I'm going to start him when he's got... He looks certainly in form, and it would be a crime not to play Shearer when he's on form the way he is. Got to play him. Just gotta do it, Captain. So that'll be my side against the Wolves side, playing a 5-3-2. Shane Longstaff, former Newcastle player there in the midfield. Anybody else? Fabio Santos and Balogun will be the front two. Ravanelli, who has scored against Newcastle previously. João Moutinho and Pedro Neto, big names on the bench, including Raul Jimenez. So Newcastle should be relatively confident of winning this game, I would think. Wolves will wear their red kits here. A Wolves side who have really struggled this season, inexplicably. And if they don't right their season soon, could be in serious trouble of getting dragged into that relegation battle. Of course, it's only 10 games into the season, so, you know, don't want to be a bit of a doomsdayer too soon. But they might fancy themselves against a Newcastle side, maybe not at their absolute full strength. Newcastle United, Diego Maradona is in talks with a few potential centre-backs, and the rumour is that he's very close to finalising the details on signing a world-class centre-back to join Newcastle United. No word on that yet. Officially who it is, speculation is rife. People talk about the likes of Virgil van Dijk, Paolo Maldini, Seydou Koulibaly, but as yet no word on who it might be. But he's certainly in the market. Here's Newcastle now, and Shearer got some space to turn. Alan Shearer, and Alan Shearer scores. That's why he's brought into the side today. Turned around, had space to shoot. And you cannot allow Alan Shearer that amount of room to lay into a shot. My word. St. James's Park, to a man on their feet to applaud the captain. And look at that. Great work there at the back by Lascelles. Won the ball. Shearer turned around and he was in acres of room. Nobody on him. No defender tracked back to catch him. No midfielder tracked back to catch him. And no defender came forward to block him. And when you give Shearer that kind of room, my word, there's normally just one result. And Kitazawa there and Howard Bellis off the bench there to congratulate them. Captain, what a pile driver that was from Shearer. Once again, he's come good yet again. Alan Shearer come good once again. Belogan does well there. Duan, who is in, I would say, yes, Saint Maximin been given a start again here, and Longstaff staying with his man. He knows what he can do. Former teammates, of course, and Shearer there chasing. Oh, taken off it there in the end. Newcastle United, of course, their Champions League campaign hanging on by a thread following their draw with AC Milan. Fabio Santos there, Fabio Silva, beg your pardon. There's Duan, who finds Mascherano. Mascherano taking on his man. Finds Adama Traore. Oh my god, and Leon Didonka there. Takes Adama out, no foul given. Andy Cole. Ooh, and Shearer there. Oh my goodness me. Won the ball back, but that's as far as they allowed it to go. And Luan now escaping the attentions of his marker there, Fabio Silva. Mascherano finds Shearer again. Luan turns away from his man. Andy Cole is there and he cannot finish it either. Mascherano does well here to win the ball back. Here's Adama Traore. Can he get the cross in? He cannot. Adama turns away from his man. Oh, fine style as well. And again, it's still Adama. Oh, tries to get the shot off and wins a corner. Adama Traore, who has said that he's been working on his end product, his crossing and his shooting. He's aware that for a player of his skill and ability, he should be subbing. And there, Adama again. Good header. That's what we're talking about. A player of his speed and strength, dribbling ability, should definitely be ranking higher in the statistics department as far as goals and assists go. And it's something he has been working on. And that taken off the toe of Andy Cole. Newcastle United's unable to win a race or a tackle. Still, I thought I'd gotten past this, but no, look at that. It just holds my man off. And Mascherano there adjusts to a foul. The winger. Yes. Michael Richards. It's Andy Cole. Tries to find Shearer and finds nobody in the end. Richards wins that one. Brings it down well as well. And look at that. Come on, ref. You tell me that's not a foul. The referee says no foul. Mike Richards wrestled off the ball and the referee says no, man. That's cool. Has been just the early call here. And here come Wolverhampton Wanderers here. Really, a lot to overcome for Newcastle. Look at that. Gavinelli sending Silva through. And Ben Foster making his debut today, actually. Debutant Ben Foster, 17 years of age. Pulled off a great save. And Foster there will collect that and ease the pressure off Newcastle United, who will go into the break a goal up. Thanks in no small part to Captain Alan Shearer, who unleashed a Scud missile from his right boot and nestled into the back of the net before the keeper even knew that a shot had been taken. Newcastle, yes, Saint Maximin hasn't really had the influence you can see in that first half. Wolves content to sit deep. Ah, Saint Maximin there tried to get past his man and just ran out of room in the end. And Shearer's there. Ooh, tried to rush his man, Alan Shearer. Luan has again not had quite the influence you would expect from him. And you would hate to say it, but is his star at Newcastle waning somewhat? It's not going, not really happening for him, is it?
Lascelles.
Lascelles Find Shearer. He tries to find Adama and does. Traore there. Shearer! It's 2-0! And that's what he'll do for you. Alan Shearer makes it 2-0. A brilliant finish. And again, it fell to that lethal right foot of his. You saw it all closing up. Adama Traore there. Oh, the defender. My word. Traore was just crowded out. And I think it was a poor touch from the defender there that fell to Shearer. And he made no mistake. Took the invitation with both hands and a right foot. And Alan Shearer scores the second of the match. Newcastle 2-0 up now. And that's what's... And shoot, man, really. Fabio Silva scores for Wolves there, and quite honestly, there wasn't a lot I could do about that, to be honest.
Yeah, that's brilliant from him. Such a calm finish.
Take a look at this goal here. He sent it, the pass went through, and for some reason, Phil Jones didn't see it, and Silva just casually ran through and placed an unstoppable shot past Ben Foster. Got a feel for the goalkeeper a little bit. A hopeful ball more than anything for Ravanelli, which Phil Jones inexplicably just didn't see. And look at that finish. Fabio Silva pulls one back for Wolves.
So now we're gonna get
and Jao Moutinho will make an appearance here. What was once comfortable is now suddenly here. Just a little bit edgy here. Jude Bellingham, haven't seen a lot of him. I think Maximin did well, they beat his man and taken out on the flank. Of course, no booking because it's only Newcastle players who are allowed to get booked, it seems. A free kick to be taken here by Javier Mascherano. Takes it and it lands in the dangerous area with nobody there. Ah, you tried, man.
Peter,
I'll
the
give you that.
Cushion is gone and it may get a little bumpier over the next
and now
minutes,
just past the hour mark.
A momentum switch. If they can gather themselves quickly, they could hit back.
And you can see unable to be tackled no matter what Newcastle United do. Luan now trying to win that one. And Mascherano. You can see the frustration now starting to tell. And Fabio Silva here equalizes, of course. Two goals from Fabio Silva. And Newcastle United from being 2-0 up. It's now brought back to 2-2. And really, there wasn't a lot that Newcastle could have done about that one either. Take a look at this. Immediate ball control, first time passes. And what you call an unstoppable sequence, really. That goal was going to happen no matter what I did. My goodness. But well played, Wolves. And well played Fabio Silva, who gets his second of the match. Now it's going to be a straight-out shootout between him and Alan Shearer, perhaps. Shearer finds Luan. St. Maximin. Oh, skips his man again, St. Maximin. Finds Andy Cole, who gets his shot off. And again, no foul given. Take a look at this. St. Maximin did well there to skip his man. Picked his pass in a crowded area. Andy Cole there. Pushed off the ball by Sean Longstaff. And the referee says, no man, that's cool. No worries. Here's Luan now. Get the ball in. Shearer's there. And Bellingham. Oh my goodness. Of course, it's blocked. Phil Jones. Here's Michael Richards. Finds Luan. Back to Richards. We find Shearer, and Shearer misses there. Oh my goodness. You can see how hard Newcastle are having to work just to stop the ball. Look at there, that shot there from Luan. And my goodness, Michael Richards very nearly dribbled himself there. The ball just bounced up and fell behind him for no good reason. And I want to take off Shearer here, but I need him so badly. If I'm going to get a goal in this game, he looks like my best hope, but I cannot. Well, he seems okay. Castona can come on, and Knight can come on, and that's all I'm gonna do. Shearer still looks good to go, actually.
Oh, that is asking for trouble.
And Luan there wins that one, and that'll be his last action of the game. Newcastle drawing at home as it stands. Mascherano wins this one. Ooh, there's a good break on here if Mascherano can find the right pass. Could yet yield the winner. Tries to find Andy Cole and fails to do so. And here come Wolves again. Ooh, and Wolves now playing the way around Newcastle. And Ben Foster does well there. And Newcastle on the break again now. They need some meaningful movement ahead of them. Here's Kieran Knight. Gets past his man. Knight again. Finds Castona. Oh my word, there's no room at all here. And Castona still keeps it. Well done. But he needs some support and there is nothing to be had.
Nice touch.
Gets across in. Shearer's there. Oh, it's saved. Shearer gets a... No, he doesn't get to it again. And it finishes 2-2. Oh my goodness me. Newcastle from being 2-0 up. Squander it all. And it finishes 2-2. I felt there was a lot going against me in that game. And it took two fantastic goals from Shearer. Look at this. What a hit, son. Get in there. Jamal Lascelles credited with the assist. But really, that goal was... All Alan Shearer, say what you will. Lascelles won it well, passed it to the only man available to him, and Shearer found himself in acres of room. And that one there skimmed the surface of the pitch as it passed the goalkeeper. A good shot there from Luan, and Andy Cole just taken off his foot there. Good save, good defending. Adama Traore, who did try it gamely on. But there's just so many Wolves. They play 5-3-2 and they were sitting deep for most of the game. So goal scoring opportunities were very hard to come by. Fabio Silva grew as the match went on. Nearly got a goal just before halftime. Ben Foster making his debut. Played a pretty good game actually, despite conceding two goals. And then Shearer here, profiting from some indecision there to put Newcastle 2-0 up. A deadly right boot of Alan Shearer. Gets another goal for Newcastle. And then in the second half, Fabio Silva, in a ball that inexplicably flummoxed Phil Jones. Ben Foster could do nothing with that. And then, just a few minutes later, it was Wolves again. Mascherano there, look at this. And Fabio Silva got his second of the game there. Ben Foster could do nothing with that either. And that's how it finished. Alan Saint-Maximin, who did... no foul given there. He did impress in spells, but... It was difficult for the attacking players to make an impression on this game. Bellingham here took this first time, and of course there had to have been someone in the way because he just had to. And Alan Shearer here, Michael Richards, got him through. Shearer, my word, that was close. A lick of paint away. And this was Castona, did well here after coming on, and Shearer right at the end. Goalkeeper alive to it. No dangerous play given, despite the foot going just past Shearer's head there. It finishes 2-2 at St. James's Park. Michael Richards and Phil Jones having stinkers at the back. And Fabio Silva there, the only player of note for Wolves. And so a draw against Newcastle. Elsewhere, Arsenal defeat Bournemouth. Leeds defeating Leicester. Man City winning away at Villa. And the big news, Manchester United's 100% record is down the toilet. They won 10 in a row. but could not pull off the trick at Anfield as champions Liverpool dropped them down a peg and say, hey man, we're still in this race, remember us? We're only the two-time defending champions. We are Liverpool and hear us roar. They've beaten Manchester United at Anfield. Big news, Chelsea losing to West Ham in that London derby. So, and Spurs win again, so Spurs quietly getting on with the job. Chelsea falling out of the top four now, Manchester City leapfrogging them. Manchester United still top of the table, but now no longer 100% record. Liverpool just 1 point behind them. That title race looks to be heating up. A title race that currently does not involve Newcastle United, who are a good 12 points behind all of the hubbub at the top of the table. It's a conversation that doesn't involve us at this point. Down at the bottom, the draw for Wolves moves them one place up and one step closer to getting out of the bottom three. The likes of Sheffield United, Leicester, Brighton, we'll be looking over the shoulders. It's really tight at the bottom as it is tight at the top. Next up for Newcastle, we travel to Selhurst Park, where we will face Crystal Palace, who are on a three-game winning streak. Crystal Palace level on points with Newcastle, and we've got to bear in mind that just 3 days later, we're going to face Real Madrid in a must-win game at St. James's Park. So, a lot happening for Newcastle. Thanks for watching, guys. Cheers.